guys, Kelsey here with another Species Spotlight. Today, we're talking about the curly tail lizards. So there's one right over here. You'll see them oftentimes standing just very still on the ground. They're a ground species of lizard. And what they're doing is they're basically just waiting for their prey to come by. So they're opportunistic feeders. He's just gonna stand pretty still. He's gonna wait for his prey. You might see them doing little push-ups almost, where they're kind of going up and down. That might be kind of a courtship behavior, or also to kind of fend off other lizards that might be in the area, so to establish territory. Also, obviously one of the most distinctive parts of these lizards are their curly tails, that's what they're named for. The curly tails could either be a form of protection, to trick predators into thinking their head is on the opposite side of their body so that when they start to run away, they run in the opposite direction that the predator expects. They could also be for courtship, so to find a mate. And then also to establish territory, so just to make them look big and intimidating so that, again, other lizards or animals do not mess with their territory. Like I said, they're ground lizards, so they are on the ground. You see them on the ground most of the time. And then they have burrows underneath the sand, so they'll actually live underneath the sand there. There can be up to 11 inches long, but they're usually about 7. So the guy that we're looking at right now, he's a baby. He looks like he's only maybe 3 or 4 inches long. They're actually an invasive species, so they're originally from the northern Bahama Islands, and they were brought to Florida to control pests on sugarcane plantations up in the mainland of Florida back in the 1940s. Quite a while now. They eat, so their prey is either insects, so beetles, ants, flies, millipedes, or other lizards. They have been known to eat the also invasive brown anoles, and people are worried that they might also be eating the green anoles, which are a native species. And then they also sometimes will munch on flowers or fruits. So they're omnivores, right? They're eating meat, and they're also eating vegetables, fruits, flowers, things like that. Again, they are invasive, and that's because they could possibly eat the green anoles, that native species, or they're an aggressive species of lizard, so they could outcompete the green anole for the green anole's food and space. And lastly, you'll see babies like this guy. He's a few months old, but you usually see the babies emerge in the early summer months, and they'll mate in